You might think city-level smart driving isn't a big deal right now, that not many people use it, but you have to pay attention to how fast this tech is developing. So today, like always, we're jumping into a super congested city road. First-person view. To see how it handles the chaos. Up ahead, we've got a right turn. And right after that, we're diving into this really messy side street. First up, a pedestrian crossing. It just yielded for them. Whoa, why did it just break like that? You probably can't see it, but there's an e-bike coming up fast on our right. Let's check the mirror. There it is. It went around us. Okay, moving on. And right away, we spot a black car just parked, blocking the lane. Man, the way people just park wherever on this street is insane. So it's not just this black car. There are two other cars on the left that are parked all weird, leaving this super narrow path for us to get through. Let's see. The car adjusts its steering, and yeah, it gets through pretty smoothly. It didn't hesitate for long, just went for it. And get this, this car is running on a pure vision system. No LiDAR. Whoa, here we go again. First, it swerves right to get around this Jaguar, then immediately left to dodge a parked Honda. After those moves, what do you guys think? How's it doing so far? Up ahead, another lane blocker, a black Model 3. The system quickly decides to go into the oncoming lane to get around it. We go another 100 yards or so and run into a really tricky situation. There's a car coming towards us, but its left blinker is on. Now, if a human was driving, you'd predict they're trying to pull into that car wash. The normal human move would be to stop and let them go first. Right. But the ADAS can't predict what the other driver is thinking yet. So it just pushes forward. I didn't intervene, cause I wanted to see how it would handle this. With that green car also parked up ahead, the ADAS is basically stuck. It ends up blocking the entrance to the car wash. Super awkward. Looking at the rear view, that other car ended up having to squeeze around our rear end. If autonomous driving is ever going to be exactly like a human, I think scenarios like this, where you have to predict another driver's intent, are gonna be a major hurdle. Of course, that's for complex predictions. For more basic negotiations, it can totally think for itself. For example, check this out. As this black car passes, the logical thing would be to go around the parked white car. Right, but watch. Our car actually stops and waits. Why? Because it spotted another car coming from the opposite direction way down this narrow road. So, the car's computer made a prediction. It chose to wait for the oncoming car to pass before trying to squeeze through. If the computer didn't make that prediction, you could easily have two cars getting stuck head-to-head in this bottleneck. And this wasn't a one-time thing. Take this situation right here. When the road is too narrow to pass, it decides to wait safely. It lets all three oncoming cars go by before it starts moving again. Or take these unprotected intersections with no traffic lights. The situation is super complex. You've got e-bikes, pedestrians, and cars everywhere. And you gotta know, with the driving culture here, it's pretty rare for anyone to yield and let you go first. But after using it for a few days, it handles these chaotic intersections safely, almost always without me having to take over. I gotta say, the progress Chinese car companies have made in smart driving over the last year is just mind-blowing. For example, we need to make a right turn here, but this BMW is blocking half the lane. In response, the car immediately adjusts, swinging out to the left, to get around the parked BMW and makes the turn normally. We even ran into a car parked facing the wrong way, blocking the lane, while testing at night. And in that situation, you can see the ADAS doesn't hesitate at all. It just pulls into the oncoming lane and goes right around it. All I can say is, man, the stuff we used to see in sci-fi movies as kids, it's slowly becoming reality. In 2025, a car's smart driving capability is the number one thing to consider. I really believe the era of smart driving for everyone isn't far off. Follow for more. And next time, I'm taking this thing out to the countryside, down some narrow alleys with no lane markings at all.